Hi guys, welcome to this session in Microsoft Visio. In this module, I want to show you how you can create a very simple floor plan using Visio. So I'm on the new screen and you can see I have a floor plan template there. I'm just going to click on that and it will open it up and give me the option to create it in metric or US units. Metric is what I'm going for. I'm clicking on create and then it will drop the grid on the screen, the template on the screen, and give me a few stencils. Now you get by default this set of stencils. If I go to the top one, you can see what you've got there. You've got quick shapes, and as I come down this list, they're just different little shapes you've got there, some drawing tools, and then you've got annotations like call outs and things like that. Annotations, building core, these are the main elements to build whatever you're trying to do. And then if I come down from building core, dimension engineering, drawing tool shapes, electrical and telecom, points of interest, and walls and structure, this is the main part of it. Now if you haven't got the actual stencil that you want there, just make that a bit wider so you can see them all, you can insert a different stencil as well. So I haven't got the stencil I want to show you in this example, so I'm just going to go to more shapes, and then you've got a list of all the other stencils that's available that you can bring into this. So we're doing floor plans, so you've got building plan there, and then there's a huge array of different stencils with lots and lots of shapes in them that you can bring into your template. So if I go for furniture, that one, that'll bring the furniture stencil in to this. So you've just got some different styles of furniture. And then what I'm going to do is just go back onto this walls and structure and give myself a room. So I'm just going to drag that on the screen. Now that's coming in as a default size of 3 meters by 2.5 meters. There's the measurements there. So it's quite a small room. Now I'm just going to make my screen a little bit bigger so you can see it better. So that's quite big now. Now what you can do is obviously you can resize this or change this, but the best thing to do is get the size and position window on the screen. Now that is in the view area, and then task panes, and then size and position. That will allow you to see X and Y where it's sitting on the paper, but also the main thing there, the width of this. So let's go for a 5 meter, let's see how big that goes, and then by 4 meter, 5 by 4 meter. So now that's gone quite large, you can see it there. I'll just move this down out of the way a little bit, so it's quite big, and it's a case of just dragging and dropping the features into your floor plan or your room that you want. So for example, if you want a door, I can stick a door in there. And that just snaps into position, and you can see the measurements of it straight away there. And again, if that isn't the right size, you can just adjust it down here. You've got this little yellow circle where you can close the door or even move it in that way, whichever way you want it to be. If the door opens inwards, which I think I'll leave it as that one, inwards. If you want the door to open the other way, you can go back to home, and then you've got position, so you can just basically flip this around. So if I go flip vertical, you can see what that does. Horizontal goes the other way, vertical opens that way, move it off back as it was. So it's totally up to you how you want that. I'm going to leave it as it is. So that's my little doorway. And then you've got windows. You can bring a window in. It's whether you bring double windows or whatever you want to bring in, you just need to drag the shape into the relevant space. So I put a window up there. Again, it's got a preset size, you can change that. I'll put a window over on this side. I'm just going to let go of that, it snaps into position, and then one more down the bottom there, so we've got a nice airy room. And as I move that across, look, you can see the line going up there, lining that up with the top one. You could just sit that in so it's in exactly the same alignment. Now on this screen, if I go to the view tab, just to make sure I've got everything ticked, if I put the grid on, you can see that a little bit better, lines things up with the grid. That's not on by default, so you'll have to tick that on, go back to home. Now if I want to put some furniture in here, I now need to get the furniture stencil, which is the one I just searched for before. So this is an array of furniture. But before I do that, I just want to talk about locking this down. When you've got an outline like that, where the windows and the doors are set in place, it makes good sense to lock that down so you don't actually move things when you're actually positioning things. You don't move the walls or you don't move plug sockets. Now, I can add a little telephone socket and you'll see what I mean by that. So if I go to the electrical and telecoms stencil, you've got telephone outlet there, so let's just sit that on. Let's see what that looks like. It's quite big. Stick it in the corner there like that. So that's that one. And what else have I got there? Television outlet, maybe you'd have that on there as well. Just sit them there. So they're connecting into the walls. I'll put it by the window actually. So if I move the walls, these would all, if I just move this down a little bit, you've now detached them from where they should be positioned, and that's what I want to avoid. So I'll just stick them back or back up so they're touching, they're connected, and then you need to lock this down. So if I do Control A, it will highlight all the shapes. So now I can create what's called a layer and then lock that into position. So you've got a sign layer first of all. If I go into that, it gives you the layer there. These are the current layers at default when you bring these shapes on. If I cancel that off, you've also got layer properties in there, layer properties, where it'll show you, and this is where you can lock it. So first of all, you need to create a new layer. So if I go into assign layer and then just go new, and I'll just call this one Steve. So this is just going to be a layer I'm going to make for this. So Steve, okay, I've created a layer. And then if we go into layer properties, you can find Steve, and then for example you could lock that, and if I click OK to this, all of this is now locked. I can't actually move this wall or I can't move these sockets or anything like that. So that's why you might want to layer things, especially if you're doing a more detailed diagram than we're doing here. So back to furniture. If I go back onto furniture, I can now start populating this with this sort of furniture you've got here. But it's really important that the furniture that you buy represents the actual size that sits in here when we do it. So for example, if I bring in a circular table, that's looking quite big, that table. If I put it in front of the window, that is telling me that the size of that, so it's over a meter across. You can change that if you want. If I put 900 millimeters and then 900 millimeters down there, that should make that a bit smaller. So when you buy things, you can see the size of it when you're buying it. So that's okay, I've done that. Let's say there's a little stool that comes in there, you sit on a stool, maybe two stools, one either side, like so. And again, the size of those you can adjust to be reflective of the actual item that you buy. Now I want to put a cubicle in here, and the cubicle is not sitting in any of these, so I'm going to search for that again. More shapes, going to maps and floor plan, building plan, and then you've got cubicles, that one I want. So if I open that one, it gives me some cubicles, so I don't have to build this up. I might just highlight these and move them a bit closer to the window to give myself a bit more space, but let's just push those over. Now, these different workstations are already preset, so if you just pick one of these, you can bring them on there. So if I try this one, let's come in with this one. So that's a desk with a computer and telephone. If I spin that round, let's say I spin that round to there, just get it horizontal, and then push it down so it sits just as you come into the door. So this might be a reception desk or something like that. And then you probably want some, this is a stool that people can sit on, it's not very comfortable, so I probably want to go and get a settee or something, see if I can fit that in. These are one single chairs, just searching for a settee. Can't actually see what I want there. I've got this sofa here which is quite big, don't want that really, so knocking that out. you've got a single chair, that would fit. But let's have a search for a sofa, see what else there is. So if I go up to the search box and type sofa, search for that. That's the one that we've got already. You've got this one. You've got this one here. Let's pull that in. That's quite big as well. But let's see if it fits. It's a three-seater, that is. So if I just put that on its side and then stick it under the window like that. So I'm happy with that. And if the size, if that's not the right size for the item that you've bought, you can just, like I said before, adjust it down here. To bring back the stencils, you need to cancel the search off, and it brings back all the rest of the stencils. And then there's not much more space in this plan here for us to put anything else in. So that's all I'm going to do on this. Now if I come down so you can see the size of the whole thing, that's how it sits. So I did zoom that in quite a bit. Now if this is a room layout that you want to replicate, what you can do is copy this and just drag it across to the next position. Before I can copy it though, because if I do Control A at the moment, it's not copying or selecting the layer that I created earlier. So what I need to do is go into layer properties and just take that tick off locked on mine. So there's Steve, tick that off, and then do Control A. So Control A will select everything. Now if I move it as a group, now if I hold my control key down there, that is just going to make a copy of it. So I've let go, and then you can put the layer back on. If I click on this, I'll just do control, I'll just select all this, not control layer, because I'll select them both. And then back into layers, lock that one down again, find Steve, tick, okay. Now that's probably locked that as well. Yeah, it has, it's locked in both because Steve's the layer and I copied the layer. Okay, but that's all I want to talk about in this little video, how you can create a very simple office floor plan using Microsoft Visio and creating a layer, adding your shapes, making sure nothing moves around when you move the actual block itself. So hopefully that was of use. Thank you for your time. I'll catch you on the next one.